Lean Sigma Mastery Collection, 7 books in 1. Lean Six Sigma, Lean Analytics, Lean Enterprise, Agile Project Management, Kaizen, Kanban, Scrum. Written by Bill Galvin. Narrated by Sam Slydell, Ted Ryan. Lean Six Sigma, Step-by-Step Guide to Improve Quality and Eliminate Defects in Any Process. Written by Bill Galvin. Narrated by Sam Slydell. Introduction. Congratulations on downloading Lean Six Sigma, and thank you for doing so. The following chapters will discuss everything that you need to know about Lean Six Sigma and how to implement it into your own business today. In our modern business world, there are many companies who are looking for ways to improve their business and see amazing results with a reduction in wastes, more efficiency, and better team culture. Nothing can promote this better than the Six Sigma methodology that we will discuss. In this guidebook, we will take some time to explore more about the Six Sigma process. What is it? Why should you use this method? What is the importance of getting certified in Six Sigma? Those questions will be answered, along with some of the myths about this process. From there, we will look at some of the steps to start and deploy the Six Sigma methodology, how to manage a team with Six Sigma, and some of the benefits of adding this method into your own business. There is just so much to love when it comes to Six Sigma, and many businesses are exploring whether it is the right choice for them or not. If you are looking for ways to improve your business and meet customer needs without waste or too much money in the long term, then Six Sigma is the right option for you. Make sure to check out this guidebook to help you get started with everything you must know about the Six Sigma process. There are a lot of books regarding this matter available at the market. Thanks again for picking this one. Enjoy. Chapter 1. Six Sigma. Six Sigma is a sort of business, the executives' methodology, that was created in 1986 by the Motorola organization. Six Sigma was created to help eliminate a lot of the waste that is found with most companies, and the goal is to get down to 3.4 imperfections per million items prepared, overhauled, or delivered. And if the company can get to even lower numbers, this is so much better. The core concept that comes with Six Sigma can be found in the idea of defects. It is not a system that is limited to assembling or development. For whatever length of time that there are defects or possibilities of defects, then the Six Sigma process can be helpful. Six Sigma is going to improve the nature of procedure yields by recognizing and after that expelling the reasons for deformities and afterward limiting inconstancy in the business and assembling forms. Variance is very important when we are looking at how to handle defects. Consistent errors are pretty easy to fix because you can just point them out, find out what is causing them, and then change up the method or the process. But you will find that sporadic errors can be hard to deal with. A good example of this would be a boss who comes into the office late each day by about 10 minutes. He's supposed to be there at 8:30 in the morning, but doesn't show up until 8:40 each day. This means that if you get to the office at 8:35, you would still be there before him, and he would never know that you were late. On the other hand, if the boss was sporadic about when they came in, it would be harder to know when you should show up. If they sometimes come in at 8:20, then other times at 9, and then another day at 8:10, there are not quality tools that are available to handle these errors. The acronym that you can use most often with Six Sigma is DMAIC. This represents define, measure, analyze, improve, and control. Define implies discovering what the necessities are from the client. The measure is a way to find out how big the problem is that you need to address. Analyze is all about figuring out the root cause of your problem. Improve is about enhancing all the positives found in the procedure and finding any arrangements conceivable to the deformities. Control is going to be the part where you develop procedures that actually work, and then control and review these procedures periodically. How is Six Sigma different than project management? Six Sigma can be seen as a type of project management tool that works for many businesses because it reduces the amount of waste and improves efficiency throughout the business. What can be successful with Six Sigma can be used, in many cases, in project management, and the same can be said going from project management to Six Sigma. Here are some of the ways that these two things may interact. 1. Both project management and Six Sigma work to come up with a sound plan, to communicate well with the stakeholders, and to make sure that resources, costs, and schedules are managed effectively. 2. Both of these disciplines are going to seek to prevent defects and reduce failures. They will work to control schedules and costs by measuring against a baseline performance of the process. They will work to determine the root causes of their variations in an effort to improve the procedures to meet and surpass the ideal execution levels. 3. Both of these are going to ensure that there is a long commitment from senior management as well as from the line laborers. Also, both to be executed completely as opposed to simply in bits and pieces or choosing what you want to work on and ignoring the rest. 4. Six Sigma is able to help out the project managers when they are gathering data, analyzing, and then evaluating the processes with the help of quantitative evaluations. Most people are scared about numbers and what they mean, but these objectives, in the long run, are going to be easier to work towards achieving compared to the qualitative ones. 5. While the project board can go into a task without full information about the monetary benefits of the undertaking, Six Sigma is going to be completed in light of hard information. It can let you know precisely what level of development you are going to get from the plan and how well you can reduce the defect rates in the process. The idea with Six Sigma is that if you are able to successfully integrate it with your project management plan, then you will be able to know exactly how much money and growth you will see. You will be able to reduce the defects, get everyone on the same page, and even reduce a considerable amount of the risks that are unknown at the time. Chapter 2. What is Six Sigma? Many of the concepts that are found with Six Sigma are going to focus on the fields of probability and statistics. You are aiming to answer the question, how confident can I be that what I plan to happen actually will happen? Six Sigma is going to deal with estimating, and after that, improving how close we can come to conveying the exact thing that we planned. However, anything that we do in business and in other areas will vary from the plan, even if it's just a little bit. Since no results are able to match our intentions 100%, it is usually going to be seen in terms of a range of acceptability. We allow for a bit of variance, but not for the complete variance when we come up with a plan for our business. The scopes of worthiness, or our resistance limits, will react to the planned utilization of the result of our works, just as the desires and needs of the client. Quality can make us stronger. In the past, traditional methods of running a business would say that the higher the quality level, the higher the cost in the long run when compared to the poorer quality. This meant that the company had to raise its prices to provide a higher level of quality, which could make them less competitive. Being able to balance high quality with an affordable and competitive price was the number one key a business had to strive to survive. The surprising discovery of those who started out with Six Sigma is that the best quality doesn't really cost more, and truth be told, it can end up costing less if you use these principles. This is because of a factor known as the cost of value. Cost of value will be the expense of going amiss from quality and can incorporate paying for things like guarantee claims, scrap, and revamp. Making things directly for your clients the first run through, regardless of whether it requires up more exertion to achieve that abnormal state of execution and quality, are really cost substantially less than making and afterward binding and fixing any deformities that are there. There are 5 steps that we talked about a bit above that are critical to the Six Sigma process. Six Sigma steps. There are 5 steps that we talked about a bit above.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.